Hey. Okay, long time no talk, but I'm up here on my beautiful New York City roof. I love a roof, by the way. I love the roof.
It's so beautiful. New York, concrete jungle where dreams are made of. Where everybody my age has rich parents, but I don't.
And that's upsetting because I wish I did. I wish I did. Welcome to Roof Talk. So I figured that I would start a new segment where we have a talk on the roof, but this will probably be the only one because I can't commit to anything. That's actually so untrue. I can commit to people. And let me tell you guys something. It seems like people can't / don't want to commit to me. Last night,
let me show you.
I was up here. We were like having some wine, and in that room, that's a hotel, that room, people were doing you know what, and we could see. And it was like,
let me tell you guys something. So the thing about me is I am a voyeur. And let me explain, because I think when you hear that, you think like, oh, that means I would want to watch that. But no, for me, it's okay. So I get it that I think voyeurism, it is inherently a sexual. I don't know what I can say here anymore. I haven't been on YouTube in so long. I don't know the rules. And I want to get paid. I need money. I'm on YouTube to make mad money. I make like maybe $4 off a video, you guys. Racking in the cash, okay? I'm taking that $4 and I'm buying me a Diet Coke. Oh, I love a Diet Coke. And yes, I know the caramel in the Diet Coke, you guys, is gonna, I'm not gonna see 30 maybe. No, I don't wanna say that because I'm pushing 30. I am pushing 30, I'm getting up there. But I know it's doing something not great to me. But yes, I am a voyeur. I am a voyeur. And I'm a voyeur in the way that I don't wanna necessarily watch what people do. That, do you like the way I said I didn't say like I don't want to watch, I said I don't necessarily want to watch, because my type of voyeurism is I would love to just watch people live their life. Like I love getting to, and that's what I love about New York, is like you can kind of just look into people's windows and like just watch them do mundane things, and there's just something about that that a lady like me enjoys. Go look in the mirror, okay? Because some of you need to go look in the mirror and realize I'm right behind you. I've been astro projecting into your home, and I've been watching you do mundane things. Yeah, I watched you do that weird shit. And I've said this before, and I will say it again. When you do something weird, and you're like, wait, that was kind of weird. No, it wasn't. That was an instinctual thing. And an instinctual behavior is not weird. It's the most natural thing you can do. I mean, New York is just so beautiful. So beautiful. And there's not as many rats as people make it seem. Like, yeah, there's rats, and they're mainly out at night, and like and when I say out, it's like you hear them, you don't see them all that often. There's not rats everywhere, you guys, and that's just something that like for me is upsetting about New York, because I wish there was. I love rodents. RIP to my hamster Ghost, who died over a year ago, and I talk about her like she's alive. I talk about how it's very noisy, by the way. I hope that's not bothering you guys, but I talk about because I don't know like how to fix that. I guess go inside, but I'm trying to have my outside time for today, be with nature. Is this nature? Is technically this nature? Is just being outside being in nature, or do I need to be around a tree? Oh, there's some trees. So I am, you see that right there? I am within nature, and the sky is nature, right? And I'm not saying that like I'm trying to be stupid funny. The sky technically is nature. Being outside is nature. We've just built stuff on nature. And technically, is that then nature? Is nature technically everywhere? Technically, if you are on Earth, are you in nature? Riddle me that, liberals. God, the debate. Back to my voyeurism, and then we'll get to the debate. No, we won't. Biden, step down. Trump, like, and just like, are we cooked, y'all? Hey guys, is America cooked? My voyeurism is I just like watching people do things. And it goes a little farther than that. My dream, and something I actively search for on different resale websites, is notebooks, old notebooks that are full, old letters that are like written, because I want to read people's shit. Not anybody I know. I think that like, yes, sure. There are some people and I'm like, let me get your phone. You give me that phone, I'm going through it, and I'm gonna enjoy my time. I feel that way, like, about a lot of famous people, like, and people IRL. But there's some famous people I'm like, oh, I'd love to go through your phone. I want to see like the photos you take. I want to see if you ever get like a weird maybe pimple, but it kind of looks like a bump on your, and you take a pic of it. I would love to see. I think that humanizes you a little bit, and maybe you guys should start sharing those posts, make a Patreon or something and share them with us. And I think that, hey, if you look, I should get into PR, because it's like, if you're struggling right now with your like relatability, you should post those photos when you get a concerning bump on your private area. And you're like, okay, this is probably fine, but you're like Googling everything, you're calling up the doc, and you're like, hey, can I, there's just like, can we just chat? Can we just, you know, I think that would make you guys a lot more relatable. So to all the celebrities watching, which I know there's a lot, I have a lot of celebrity friends. I'm very famous. I'm very within the famous world, famous people. Okay, that bit's not, it's not even funny. Voyeurism. So I also collect vintage jewelry, right? And I found this truly stunning piece. Basically, it's gold, real gold. And yes, I have gold. I have gold family heirlooms. It's not my family, but it is a family, and it has the name. Pardon, I had a little burpee. Why don't we publicly burp and fart? I would love to know when the shame over that started, over when like, oh, you can't do that around other people. I guess burping is more normalized, but farting, when did that become a shameful thing? Like, when in history? Do any historians watching know? Or do I need to become the historian that figures that out? Maybe I actually make a long-term, like long video on that. Like, when did farting and talking about pooping become a shameful thing? When like, that's like a way that we void things out of our body. It's essential and healthy and good for us. And if you're not doing it, that's like, I wouldn't say shameful, it's like concerning. And it's like, oh, babe, let's get to the doctor. You know what I mean? You know what's so upsetting about the state of the world is I just said doctor, and I'm over here like, the way going to the doctor is a privilege, and the way like a lot of doctors are actually horrible and like don't listen to you. It's so hard to live in this world and be a silly goofy girl and want to get on here and say pee pee poo poo, fart fart, let's all fart in front of each other. But then it's like, oh, but there's like real life stuff going on, and like I can't escape it. And I'm also wearing this Harley Davidson shirt with like American Eagle on it, and I look so like, and I'm wearing this because it's like, I think it's a cool shirt. Other people like think it's cool, but then it's also like, okay, but that like kind of symbolizes America and like that group of people that believe, even though a lot of them are just brainwashed into believing it, brainwashed by intentionally being undereducated by Republicans and by liberals so that they will buy into what they're saying and mean, okay, and make them believe that like the things that would benefit them are things that like will not, and other people shouldn't have them when they need them. It's okay, and I'm wearing that like it's cool, and I'm also wearing gold. And look at the roof I'm on and look at the way I'm talking. Yeah, it's crazy. And then this necklace has a pendant from my ex. Recent, very recent ex, as in like today. But I'm okay. It was planned. It was a planned breakup. I'm gonna take it off and I'm gonna put it in my little memory box where I keep all my other stuff with all my other exes. But it's okay. I'm okay. It's for like the best, you guys. Did I ever finish my voyeurism stuff? I like being a voyeur. I think like us loving watching people eat like on YouTube and stuff, like there's so many different types of eating videos on YouTube. That's voyeurism, right? Our obsessions with room tours, what's in my bag, like, or is that just interest in others? Is that just our inherent human interest in others and wanting to see how similar we are and wanting to get like inspiration? I need to Google the definition of voyeurism, actually. Hold on, because I don't even know if I know what voyeurism means at this point. So it is gaining that type of pleasure from watching people do intimate things. But like, I just enjoy, or I enjoy watching people do intimate things, but not like just like normal things. Like, so maybe I'm using the wrong word. Maybe I'm just like really interested in people, or maybe I'm just like a stalker. No, because I would never stalk anybody. That sounds actually like really scary to stalk somebody. I'd be scared to stalk somebody, and I wouldn't want to do that. It's actually really annoying how difficult speaking and articulating my thoughts can be. And sometimes I sound like a fucking idiot And I'm like, I promise I'm not. I just can't, like, get it out correctly in this moment. But I also don't really care if somebody thinks I'm dumb, because there's nothing inherently wrong with being dumb. I've also been squinting this whole video because of the sun. I don't really know where I'm at. Basically, I've missed YouTube though, you guys, and I'm gonna be back. I'm just gonna be like making videos like this. Probably not on like roofs, or maybe like I can go on like different roofs. All my videos are on roofs now. No, because what if I fall off one? Like, I know I would get maybe a little risky. No, I wouldn't. I'm really not a risk taker. And I think that's a good thing. Like, I take risks, sure, in some ways, but they're calculated. It's a calculated risk. I'm not a risky person, and I don't think that's bad. I don't think you need to be a risk taker to, like, achieve greatness. You just need to be confident. So it's like, this isn't like a huge risk. It's like, I believe in myself. So maybe it is. I'm here to say pee pee poo poo and make you guys giggle, not like... Oh, did I ever finish saying what this bracelet was? It is from a mom back in the day, I'm assuming, and it has her 5 children's names and their birthstones, and I love it, and I wear it every day because this is my family now. I also have this pendant, and it's this vintage locket, and it has like a family in it. Going to Miami in a couple days. Maybe I'll find a rooftop up there. I'm excited. I gotta get a swimsuit. And here's my issue, guys, is I don't shave, and my hairline in a certain spot goes out kind of far, and so I have to do something about that. Not because it's like, oh, I don't want to do anything. Also, there's like a camera right there, so technically, like, they're voyeuring on me talking about this. If they're listening, hey, subscribe, like and comment, follow my Instagram, both of them, my jewelry one and that, and maybe check out my TikToks, give them a like and comment. My recent TikToks have been flopping, like, I mean, like 200 300 views, and the thing is, I don't even care that they're not getting views, but I also at the same breath would love to have a lot of views on everything I do, but I don't really care enough to actively like try. I'll give like a little bit of energy, not a lot. You guys, I start things and I never finish them. I also like did not get sleep last night. Right now, you're getting me half asleep. Anyways.
So pretty. It's so pretty. When was the last time you guys were on a roof? It's really pretty over there. Maybe we walk over there and look, but I don't feel like getting up. So you guys are just going to have to take my word for it. Because I'm lazy. There's the Statue of Liberty right there. I'm just kidding. I'm just goofy. I'm just kidding.
Lady Liberty. You know the Statue of Liberty is a hologram? Like, it's not even real. Sorry. You know, it's like when... I start filming too long and those are the jokes. Those are the jokes that you guys start getting. And I don't even know if I've been funny this video. You guys, I actually don't think I'm funny anymore. I think that I can only be funny around funny people or by myself. But I'm starting to think that I can't even be funny by myself. Hey, do you guys think I've been funny? Validate me in the comments down below. If you don't think I've been funny, lie. I never said you had to be honest. I will take lying validation. That's the thing. Like, I don't need total honesty. I actually would prefer to be lied to if it's going to build me up. Because there's no reason to be, like, honest if you don't think I'm funny. Someone commented on a TikTok video I made where I was wearing this outfit. It was like a jersey top and then like these little like shorts, and it wasn't a great fit, but it was like I wanted to make a little like silly goofy video for TikTok with like a little text thing. And so, like, you know, I set the camera up and I'm doing it on the streets while there's people, you know, I'm trying to like time it so no one has to watch me do this so I'm not embarrassed. And then someone commented, girl, this outfit is not eating the way you think it is, and nobody's going to tell you, so I'm going to tell you. And then someone, like, replied to it and was like, I know, like, her shorts that she's wearing under it. Well, they said that the dress you're wearing under it is jersey material, so it looks like you're a PE teacher. But the gag of it all was I was not wearing a dress. I was wearing shorts. But both of those comments were valid. The outfit didn't eat the way... Not that I thought it ate, but I did like it. And I still do stand by that outfit. But, like, I did look like a PE teacher, but that was kind of like the vibe. And I look like a Pinterest girl. And I've, that picture is already like, some people have been screen grabbing it. A bunch of people actually, and have been putting it all over Pinterest. Who? Me? No, I didn't do that. Should I start doing that? Should I start putting myself on Pinterest? I see my jewelry on Pinterest sometimes, and I don't do that. I don't put it up. So shout out to whoever's done that. Life is weird, you guys. Life is weird, but life is good. We need to learn. Okay, that beep, I don't know if you guys heard that. It sounded like it said Amy. You know that like one phenomenon that like we hear our name in songs? Interesting. Interesting. Is a lot of times our issues aren't actually even issues. I mean, they're issues, but once you decide they're not an issue, it's not an issue anymore. But it still can be very much an issue. But if you decide it's not an issue, it's not an issue, even if it is an issue. So I've been doing that a lot, and it's really dangerous. It's really dangerous, and I'm disappointing people. But I'm getting peed. No, I'm not like disappointing that many people. I'm not that selfish. Like, I have like some selfish tendencies, but for the most part, I'm really not selfish, and I actually, that's an issue, I think, for me, and I think I need to become more selfish. I'm gonna head out, but I love you, and I miss you guys. I'm gonna come back to YouTube. Yeah.